Greetings. Thank you, Jedi, for your very thoughtful questions. I will handle them in individual videos. Hello. If Satan was in heaven and God cast him out, that means Satan knew who God was. Why the hell then would he ask if? I believe this refers to the temptation of Christ, where Satan asked, or challenged, with, "If you be the Son of God." You then provide the following example as an attempt to clarify your point. I think your point was already quite clear. That's like as if you knew your dad and then saw him a few years later and said, "If you're my dad, then..." I completely respect your question, Jedi, because it shows genuine, original thought, and I appreciate your example. Let us reason together and apply Christian definitions to explain the Christian concepts you question. In order to discuss your question, a foundation that we must completely understand is the following. John 4:24, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. This is absolutely fundamental to understand, Jedi. Also notice, in this context, Jesus says God and not the Father. We should recognize this leaves the door wide open as reference for the triune God and not God the Father alone. That point can be further supported by simple analysis. Let's assume it means God the Father and it declares God the Father is a spirit. From other scriptural references, we know the Holy Spirit, or Holy Pneuma, is a spirit. Same Greek word, pneuma. And by reading the Word of God, we learn Jesus too is a spirit. Hebrews 5:10. Therefore, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me." Now, think carefully about that last phrase. A body you have prepared for me. If you prepare something, a meal, for example, for someone, the someone is separate from the meal. Jesus the Messiah, in this verse, refers to himself with the pronoun me. A body you have prepared for me. Jesus, therefore, cannot be the body which was observed walking the earth. The body was prepared for Jesus to use. What then is Jesus? Jesus is the spirit that lived in the body. So God the Father is pneuma, or spirit. God the Holy Spirit is pneuma, or spirit. And Jesus is a spirit who lived in the body God prepared for him to use. So let us use this knowledge to address your question, brother. Hello. If Satan was in heaven and God cast him out, that means Satan knew who God was. Why then would he ask if? The context of your question deals with a location, right? If Satan was in heaven. Satan was in heaven before Satan was cast out. In heaven, what was Jesus? Meaning, what form was he in? Jesus was pneuma, or spirit, an eternal spirit that existed with God before the creation of the physical world. We know this from something Jesus himself prayed. John 17:5. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world existed. According to Jesus, Jesus existed with God before creation. If Jesus existed before creation, Jesus could not have had a physical body. the physical body and appearance that Jesus would have in the physical world could not exist until that physical world had been created. And then only after God prepared a body for Jesus to occupy, to utilize while Jesus was in the flesh, in the earth. So when Satan was in heaven, Jesus was a spirit, but Jesus did not have the physical body he would later occupy. Think about that, brother. It highlights an assumption in your example which has caused you some confusion. That's like as if you knew your dad and then saw him a few years later and said, "If you're my dad, then." The oversimplification in the example is that the Father is exactly the same at both times. In the case of Jesus, adding a body is like adding a total change of appearance. Satan, therefore, could have no idea what the body would look like when Jesus received the body that was prepared for him. As I said, I appreciate your question as completely original, at least to me. I've never heard a Muslim apply such advanced thinking. But I believe there is a deeper question you may have overlooked. As you point out, Satan was in heaven and knew God. You have focused on "if you are" for your cogitation and examination. The question "if you are" only makes sense in the context that God has a son. Please think about that a moment, Jedi. Satan was in heaven and Satan knew God, right? This is the foundational position of your consideration. The statement Satan should make comes straight out of Islam. Not "if you are," but "God has no son." Now think about this carefully, brother. I am not saying Islam's statement is correct. I am saying if Satan knew God from heaven and God had no son in heaven, the only comment by Satan that would make sense, if Satan met someone claiming to be the Son of God, would be, "I was in heaven, I know God, and God has no son." Yet that is not Satan's jihad, is it? Instead, Satan challenges whether Jesus is the Son of God. The second implication, brother, is that Satan was expecting the Son of God to come to earth at some point. So regarding your first question, why then would he ask if Satan knew God had a son? But Satan knew the Son of God only as a spirit. Satan could not know what body would be prepared for the Son of God, or what that body would look like. And Satan was also expecting the Son of God to one day come to the earth. That is why Satan asked, "If you are," instead of saying, "You cannot be, God has no son." May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.